This is the album by Jaden Smith called Iris.
Evil's invisible, so I keep a lot of vision.
Every night I try to vision, when I see you, see your eyes. Don't let me catch her, I won't waste your time, cause I'll never know what's in the soul.
This is gonna be brotherly review, family edition. We have my brother-in-law, I guess, here. His name is?
Mebrak.
Mebrak. Say that again one time.
Mebrak.
Okay. All right. I got my bro right here. You already know Truth and Trees. We like to start an episode off with a little energeticness. So we're going to jog the block Isaac. 5 minutes. Then we're going to come back and do a music review on 2 tracks off of the new album, Iris. But whatever. Here we go, guys. We're just going to jog. Before you know it, it'll be over. Come on, guys. This is the checkpoint.
Follow me on Instagram or check out my website. Today is going to be actually a family review episode. We just finished doing a beautiful jog around the block. We have some family here from London.
This guy's sweating right now.
He's sweating like, I'm sweating so much I don't even see him on the camera. I mean, I guess you could kind of see it. But yeah, we're all sweating pretty much a 5 minute jog around the block.
Yeah, if that wasn't obvious, but yeah. We're from England, basically.
Music is a language, it's a key to the soul, you know? I think it plays a profound impact on society itself.
Personally, I'm no musical boffin, so yeah. I don't feel like I can go into like the technicalities of it.
I would say like, you guys don't really have to be technical, but you know, just off of like the first listen, just like how did it make you feel?
This particular song, one thing I liked about it was I liked the beat, there was a lot of space. So if you lifted his voice off of it, and you just listen to the chords, there was like some open chords there, so there was a lot of space for emotion, for your own emotions to flow through the song. Oh. So I think that was quite beautiful.
That was really interesting because the harmony was really different. It wasn't conventional. It was like, that's the type of like urban music that I like, when it's not too mainstream, it's got like something interesting that's just a bit
just different. A small piece or something.
Yeah,
that's
like,
different.
Harmonically, yeah.
Cutting them all, them kids go hard.
You know, I think that, you know, the way they say that it's a language of the soul because the way music influences people through the vibration. You know, vibration is ultimately a frequency, and there's this specific frequency with different genres of music. So you have classical, you have jazz, you have hip hop, you have R&B. And I think a lot of, you know, the best artists know how to tonally resemble in certain vibrations in their album to basically, make the album sound versatile, even though you might think of this one artist as a hip-hop artist or a rap artist or whatever it may be. So I think Jaden Smith is a poetically inclined artist.
Feeling psychedelic by the story, let me tell it. It's a boy in his bedroom with a pencil about to renovate the world. Many thought he couldn't do it, though from heaven fell a girl.
You know, I think when I first started listening to his music in high school, you know, he touched the words on a paper to make it sound more poetic. But as I listened to this album, you know, as said before, me and my brother heard it, but, you know, Shema and Mebrak haven't heard it yet. I think that the album was more geared to the mainstream. Mainstream music, there is a threshold. There's a threshold that you have to cross as an artist in order for you to have this particular sound. So it might sound a little bit more heavy on the bass hits and like more frequently attuned to, you know, the hype of especially this particular song, you know, the hype at the end of the song, at least, you know, the hype of.
Got a vision, shoelace in a spot, got a fist full of guap, by the.
So like a lot of times I'm listening to go to sleep, and I think part of the reason is because when that first starts, like you feel, I like how the beat switches, but I like that first beat that they have in the beginning.
Yeah, so the first beat is really nice. There's a lot of open chords, there's a lot of space in
Rebel Child.
For your own emotion.
Because sometimes we forget it, like, even though there's an artist to a song, sometimes if you're going to a song, like, that beat is really touching you too, so.
Yes. Yeah. Like when you're just sitting and you listen to instrumentals and, you know, it brings a certain feeling, and I think he he was kind of clever with that. Even though his voice is on there, there's this openness to the chords that kind of allows your own emotions to run through.
And to put out, but just my type of music that I prefer to hear would be a little bit more poetically inclined as far as the lyricism behind what he's speaking on. And I just would have liked him to bring more of that out, mm-hmm. you know, throughout the album. And I think that he was geared more towards...
It's funny, we have definitely different perspectives. I feel like he did, but you know, he had a lot more, more poetic in the last album. But I definitely, one reason I really like this song, I like how he starts it off and he's like, he's talking about a story and he's talking about like she was floating through the air and like he's
marble feather in her hair, she was swimming through the air. Then she turned to woman, looked and said,
I like the way he describes different parts of what he's thinking about as far as love and girls and his interests. But to me, that's like the small poetic parts that he has like up in this song. But definitely, it would be nice maybe to listen to Sire and then listen to this and then see the poetic aspects of both. But
one song we're gonna play. This one's a lot shorter, and this one is actually featuring Kid Cudi. Everyone should know Kid Cudi, and I think it's gonna be a pretty good listen.
Niggas try to hate on us. Ain't worried about the things since I'm strong enough. The feeling just don't stop in there. Baby, yeah, we can go up.
I like it because it kind of like makes you feel uplifted. Like
I don't know. I think
that's a heavy beat as well.
It's a dark beat. It's a heavy beat. I just like
it reminded
they use it in a way to uplift. You know, that's what I like. Mm. Like you know, in your soul. When I hear that in your soul, it's like it makes me feel high. It doesn't make me feel low.
Well, the soul is hidden. The soul is hidden. Everything comes from the dark. Everything comes from the black. Let's get that straight off. You know, everything comes from the black. So in your soul is dark. That's that spirit. They trying to hit you in the spirit. The spirit is intangible. You can't see that. So for one person, it might mean for somebody else. But like, it's gotta be with inside of you. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I think it resonates to that deeper part. You know, to that deeper part. To that, it could be dark. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But that's just what I choose terminology of it. But you know, some people might think about it as light. Yeah. I don't. You know, but
it's definitely.
Yeah,
heavy.
Music
definitely
is subjective in that sense. Mm-hmm. I guess one thing that you can hope is that making this album was fulfilling for him, and that he has been able to
touch whoever he is,
express his vision in the way that he hopes, and that this isn't just what we think it is, which is that he's just gearing towards the mainstream and he's just trying to get himself out there, and that's what it is for him, but rather that the music is coming from that place.
You can go for the last song, how like he has a lot of switch ups. This one, I didn't really think about it because like I've heard the album so many times, and like when the switch up comes, like I know and I feel it, and I'm like, okay, I'm ready for the switch up. But since you guys brought it up now, I think, okay, he does a lot of songs where he does switch up, and then he has, like, those 808s, and he kind of kicks it in there. Mainstream, the way you guys are kind of thinking about
it. Setting a tone.
It.
He's setting a tone. He did it again in this song at the end. Mm-hmm. You know, not to say that that's a bad thing, but you could see the audience that he's gearing for through those transitions, you know?
It's like, oh, if I didn't catch you in the beginning, I'm going to catch you at the end.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Some, you know, what...
Yeah, I think it was good. I like this transition more than the one before. Mm-hmm. It made more sense because like the music, even though it's a transition, it still felt like it was one thing.
Yeah.
Whereas the last piece
was more cohesive, definitely.
Yeah, exactly. The last one felt like it was three separate things.
Yeah.
In one of the tracks on his album, he says, I just hope that they get the metaphors because I put a lot in them or something like that. You know what I'm saying? So I hope that people get the metaphors or the similes or whatever he's talking
about. They're not getting the vision.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But because he puts a lot into that. Like in one of the songs, he talks about that. And, you know, I think that, you know, that's just profound in itself.
I would say listen to the deluxe edition. It's a lot longer. It's an hour and 18 minutes, but I think you will enjoy it. And maybe you find some gems in there. If not, it's okay. Music is subjective. But yeah, shout out to Jaden Smith. And looking forward to working with you in the future. And that's it. That's how we gotta do. We just gotta keep growing, keep moving. And we're all on our own path. And this has been the Brotherly Review.
Hi, guys.
Thank you. My bond open wide, in the soul. Hard off and I'm floating wide, in the soul. I love Jaden Smith. Me and my bro Marlon, we actually both love Jaden Smith, and we've been kind of following him on his journey since, like, when he was like in his teens, 2011. He dropped like some beautiful songs, and I'm just watching him grow. And I'm an artist as well, so it's been cool like watching him grow. He's 19, I'm 22, and I kind of been growing with him at the same time.
He just turned 21.
Oh, he just turned 21, so we're even closer than I thought. So, nice. it's cool to see the growth of him as an artist, and now I'm seeing my growth of myself as an artist through just being influenced by him and other people. And it just was really inspiring to me, listening to the album. Like, I listened to it at like 5 o'clock in the morning, I was on my way to the gym. I was like, oh, okay, writing some music. And then he dropped his album, then I'm listening to it for like a good like 4 days now, just really bumping it and like really feeling it. And on a quick note, when Sire came out, his last album, my brother sent it to me, and I didn't really like it when I first heard it. And then I loved it after a while, like a couple months later, I heard this tune again. I was like, whoa, I'm kind of going crazy, why didn't I like it? And reason why I wanted to do this brotherly review, or family review, is because music hits us in different points of our lives, and we all have different perspectives. So I might like something, or I might think something's awesome. And then my cousin, my Brock, he would hear it, and he might be like, oh, no, that's not good, or he might actually love it more than me. So with Jaden Smith's album, I heard it like probably about 5 times. I really loved it. Just keep it on repeat right now before I move to my next songs that I want to hear. And then my brother Marlon, he's heard it a good time through, and he has his own perspective on it. Shema, my brother's girlfriend, she has actually not heard the album at all yet. And then we have my Brock, he has not heard the album as well. So we're going to play 2 songs from the album, just get the perspective between each song.
The specific sounds were geared to like more 808s, that's...
Yeah, that bass pumping.
Yeah.
Misleaders. True wealth is knowledge. They don't try